do.
Smoking weed in the street without cops harassing. Imagine going to court with no trial. Lifestyle cruising blue behind the waters. No welfare supporters.
Good. Okay. Welcome everybody. This is episode 18 of Include Xclude. My guest today ahead of me is a wonderful person. Caring, smart,
wow,
technical.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying all this good shit.
That's some good shit. Right? I don't know if I'm all stuff.
Oh, man. Well, if you weren't that, I wouldn't have you. If you weren't that, you wouldn't be here on the show today.
Thank you.
But
appreciate that.
No problem, man.
I just try to be like a normal dude.
Normal dude.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Treat people like, you know, you want to be treated.
Exactly, man.
Exactly.
And you probably already know Raymond Wilson. Thank you for being on the show. Thank you for spending your time with me today.
No worries, my man.
Oh, dude, how was your weekend, or how was your past weekend?
Very, very quiet, actually. You know, I work Monday through Friday all week, and when I get off, you know, I want to do music. I'm trying to, you know, build my repertoire as far as my genres of music that I'm doing, and get better. You know, you always can improve when you're doing your music. You know what I mean?
Gotcha. And I've never got into production or anything like that. That's kind of an area like to where I'm kind of in between. Like, I've listened to so many tracks, and you as well. You listen to so much music that it's like, oh man, you always come up with an idea and it comes to you like in the middle of the night, so to speak. But I can't translate my thought in my head to a keyboard.
Well, that's it. And I'll be honest with you. That's one of my biggest problems, because I was never taught how to play a instrument.
Gotcha.
So when I'm doing a lot of my productions and stuff like that, you know, and I'm making beats or whatever, I have to rely on samples, which I hate doing. And I'll be honest with you, you know, you don't get a lot of respect for doing that. But when you don't have the knowledge of how to play, you have to translate your ideas somehow.
Gotcha.
And you have to use samples sometimes.
Sure.
That's, you know, and that's what I do. I use a lot of samples, but I try to make them original. You know what I mean? Put my own little spin on the sample. You're changing.
Sure. Put your own remix to it.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You know?
And also, what are you producing lately, or what have you? Is it more like housey, tech housey kind of stuff?
Let me explain.
Sure.
See, me growing up, because I'm an older guy, you know what I mean? I've been doing this a long time. The era I grew up in was, you know, hip hop era.
Sure.
So a lot of myself, when I started first producing, or start making beats for, like, it was like for rappers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was a lot of hip hop I was doing, but now I'm transitioning to house.
Gotcha.
So there's a lot of stuff that I have to learn about house.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Sure.
So that's what I'm doing now.
When
not as new stuff mm-hmm. that I'll be producing will be more housey.
When I was speaking to Pretty Digital, shout out to Bobby if you're listening right now. But mm-hmm. when I was speaking to him, he produces a lot of different genres, like hip-hop and pop kind of stuff. And he came from that background. Now he's doing techno. He's
right.
With Felsy. Shout out to Felsy.
Oh, Felsy.
Yeah,
that's my
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
That's my man. I miss Felsy. Yeah, yeah. That's what's up.
Yo. But I when I was first coming up as a DJ, like, I was hanging with the hip-hop guys just as well. Like,
right.
DJ Cutlass and J-Rock mm-hmm. and a couple other cats. And that's I was first developing, like, kind of my talent, my skill, by doing the DJ cafes,
mm-hmm.
which is basically, you know, you bring your equipment, you bring your gear, and you do like a quick 10-minute set.
Right.
It's meant for scratching and stuff like that.
Right.
But I was like the only, well, one of the only house dudes, and I was just doing my own thing, just learning on the fly. Like, granted, I would mess up, and sometimes I wouldn't, but I didn't care because I was among this group of talented people who've performed in front of, you know, big crowds.
Right.
So I was like, you know, if I can hold it down with them and learn a thing or two from them, I can roll it, I can take it from there. And then that starts slowly to go out. More and more, I'm meeting people like you. It's just awesome.
Exactly.
Shit.
Exactly. And, yeah, I mean, I miss hip hop, but I've grown. I got a little older, so I really can't feel it like I used to.
Gotcha.
I've grown to love dance music.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because sometimes I feel like hip hop has gotten to a point where it's there and it can't go any further.
Right. To me, the echelon of like what rap was me like listening to Nas, like Illmatic.
Right, right.
And, like, you know, he's going through the struggles of, you know, his time in Brooklyn. Not how Brooklyn is now, because it's gentrified, for lack of a better word. But you see that struggle with him, his buddies getting shot. You know, he's going through his own internal pain and struggles, and you see that being presented
right
in his lyrics, and that's mm-hmm. so awesome. You know, listen to him, listen to the Busta Rhymes, listen to
but they are the greats though.
Yeah, I know
where are they at? That's what I'm saying, like, where are the greats at? They should still be out there making stuff, because you don't have sounds like that anymore.
Right. Jadakiss made a new album.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, but
relatively new.
Okay.
Relatively new. I want to say maybe it's about a couple months old.
Okay.
But you know, I heard there's some bangers on there too.
That's what's up. Yeah. That's what's up.
I know. I'm glad people like that are still doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And speaking of which, I just heard Richmond Dino, mm-hmm. local hip hop house DJ around here. He's I heard him last night at the Rock Garden near the Art Museum.
Yeah, yeah.
And he hadn't been out in, I want to say, like seven. Like he's always constantly touring.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like, it was his first time being out and playing in like 7 months, something like
really?
That, something long like that. He was playing vinyl at night,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, wow, that's some crazy shit. And people were moving. They had a little jerk chicken stand.
No.
Yeah, no, they did. It was good.
What?
It was good. Had a little sauces. Like, it was like $10 for like a
platter.
A platter, yeah. It was like you know, cut up jerk chicken and with like a little slice of bread. You know, and like you choose your choice of like soda or water, either that. But it was still good.
That's all good.
Like when it's like midnight, it's like you got to eat something, you know, just to kind of make it through the night.
You better eat something.
I know, for real.
Because every time, I swear, listen, every time I leave a gig now, like we just did one last weekend, you know.
Yeah.
You were there. And I left around a little bit after midnight. And I'm like, listen, I got to get something to eat. Because I had a couple.
Sure.
Couple brews,
some wine
and stuff like that.
You were working it. Yeah, you were working.
Yeah, then I had to DJ, know what I mean? And listen, this is the hardest part. Like, when you DJ, because my set was around 7 o'clock, and I was there around 2-ish, 3-ish, around that time. And from between that time, between 3 and my set, I was, like, putting some back. So I'm like, whoa, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But I love DJing, like, not with, like, a little, what's that, I'm gonna say it. Not a clear head.
Oh, gotcha.
I like to be in my element.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
It's like sometimes when I'm in my own head, when I'm feeling just the way you're feeling, I'm kind of like I'm putting my own little spin and twist on it. To a degree, it's like you have more flow sometimes.
Exactly.
I put that out there on the International DJ Cafe Facebook group page, and I was like, man, do you think you play better with like a couple beers in you, something like that.
Right.
And it was like hit and miss. Some people was like, it's like, yo, I could do it. I could do it sober. I could do it with a few beers in my tank. And some people were like, I got more flow. Like, I need it.
You need it, right?
Yeah.
Right. You need that.
I've heard like even more like, I don't want to say severe because that's the wrong word, but I've heard people like on K like spin.
Yeah.
And like, that's a thing. Holy shit. Like, I can't believe you could put two of these sounds together and make it sound good. It's something about that like thought process that makes everything seem seamless.
To me, it takes the edge off.
Sure.
Of that
I
edge,
agree.
Like, oh man, how I'm going to sound?
Right.
How my mixes are going to sound?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Are they going to like what I'm playing? You know what I mean? When you're in your element and you don't get that edge off, you don't care.
Right.
You just play.
Just go
for it. You know what I'm saying? And I love that. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because you have to be in that place.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And then I hear the music, and I hear certain elements in the song, and I'm feeling it. I'm grooving.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right, exactly.
And I know, and when I'm grooving, right, I feel like the people out there that's watching me are grooving. They where I'm at that place in time.
Exactly.
They can feel what I feel.
Exactly. They're moving.
Exactly. And that's the best feeling ever.
That's an incredible feeling.
You know what I mean?
That's something you can't really... You can't really touch, taste, or feel. Well, you can feel it, but it's like you can't. it's so like visceral. I don't know. You can't describe it, but you know what I'm talking about. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. If you listen to that, yeah,
yeah, of course they do. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. Yeah, like when you in that in your zone, man, and everybody in their dance zone, and they feeling what you're playing, and they dancing and moving. You know what I mean? Y'all in this place all together, and that's why I love music, man. Because everyone feels the same. You know what I mean? And you're just like, yes, you can put your hands in the air. You know what I mean? Or do whatever you want to do and just feel it.
Did you had a great set, by the way. Fantastic set.
Did you like my set?
I did like your set.
Listen.
Despite you telling me that you had the echo on for the majority of your set, everybody was moving and nobody cared.
And listen, to all DJs that are listening out there right now, please check your settings before you start playing. And this is what I'm saying. I think I was too much in my element.
Okay.
And I didn't check everything like
got
I was supposed
you,
to check.
You, got you.
And I didn't know that the echo was on the cue. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, why am I hearing double beats while I'm mixing? And I'm like, this is off. But I had to keep going because mm-hmm. what did you go and do? I can't stop.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, wow, my set is going to be terrible. But everybody was saying like, right, your set was cool. Mm-hmm. I'm like, to me, knowing that something was wrong, I can't believe it.
Got you.
It's hard. And this is why I should have just checked everything. Because Carlos was like, great, check all your settings. He said it. And I thought everything was mm-hmm. cool. So I didn't do my job. And I have to, you know.
Got you. But regardless, everybody was in a good place.
Right.
And I'm glad stuff like that is still going on.
Right.
Despite the time that we're in now. You know, little spots like that, nook and crannies within the city that while we can, you know, kind of be ourselves mm-hmm. is very relieving, you know, during this time. Now, I'm glad it's happening. Mm-hmm. It's going to be few and far in between, but, you know, we're slowly come back from that. Like, I was just on Instagram earlier today. I believe on The Conscious. I forget the dude's name. I met him in New York, but his Instagram is The Consciousness. Right. And literally last night, there was another party like along a pier, kind of sort of in New York, like in Brooklyn, I would assume. Right. And that's, you know, that's steadily going on, you know. And even not even the pier party in Brooklyn that I saw on Instagram, I know there was an official event at this club called Barcode,
right,
in New York, in Brooklyn. And Layton Gordini and A Vision from Drum Code. We're playing at brunch, like from noon to like 7 p.m. And they were jamming, playing techno. I was debating about going. I'm like, I'm not a big fan of that drum code kind of sound.
Okay.
I'm not a big fan of it. I was into drum code before, but I'm like, I was kind of debating whether or not I should go or not. And I was like, I'm going to stay put because I know there was stuff happening here tonight. So I was like, no, keep it local. Keep it local. And that's fine.
Keep it local, yeah.
But how did you get into the nursing field? Are you an RN, I believe?
No. Okay, no, gotcha. I'm a phlebotomist.
Phlebotomist, okay. Could you...
phlebotomist what is that? One who draws blood.
Okay.
So that's gotcha. What I do all day.
Okay.
For 5 days a week, some days, 6 days a week, I draw blood.
Gotcha. God bless you for that.
Yeah. Yeah, because a lot of people can't do it.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Gotcha.
And it's a little technique, and there's a lot that you have to know and be able to deal with in certain situations, because mm-hmm. a lot of people don't like it. Then you have some people that like I don't like it a lot so much that I'm going to faint on you.
Gotcha.
So you have to
like
be
eat something. Like, yeah. I'm guessing, like, to prevent fainting.
That's the problem. That's why people faint, because you can't eat before you get your blood drawn. Mm. So, because you have to fast. So, a lot of people, plus, there's a lot of anxiety, and a lot of people are nervous when they get in there, get in the chair, and I'm like, oh, I can't take this.
Dude, I got to know my blood type. I don't even know my blood type. Well, I don't know if it's type O or if it's
A lot of people don't. I mean, to be honest with you, I don't even know my own blood type, and I draw blood every day. Mm-hmm. Because the only time you really need to know your blood type is if you're going to have an operation, and you might need a blood transfusion. Sure. Or, you know, like an emergency operation.
Some kind of serious, I would say.
Some serious, right. Yeah, that's when the doctor was like, you have to get your blood type, you know what I mean? But mm-hmm. usually you don't have to know. Okay. Unless you go and donate blood, like for the Red Cross, something like that, you're good to go. Don't, you know, it's not a real big deal.
Why did you get into that field to begin with?
How did I get in, what, the field on blood?
Correct. And or in that kind of hospitality kind of field.
Well, that's a long story, my man, but I'm going to keep it short.
Sure.
I was in a dead-end job. Mm-hmm. And I hated it. And I had a buddy who went to school for phlebotomy at Monco. And I'm like, he was like, hey, you know what? why don't you try going to school for phlebotomy? I was like, dude, I can't because I don't like blood. Anytime I see blood, I'll faint. And he was like, come on, Ray, you'd be good at it. You're good with people. You'd be great. And I said, you know what? He kept bugging me like every week to go to school for phlebotomy. Mm-hmm. So I said, you know what? I kind of hate what I'm doing now. I won't put it out there what I was doing, you know.
Sure.
But I said, okay, I went to school. I'm going to go. It's only, to be honest, it's only a 15-week course. 15 weeks. That's sure. It. But it's the best decision I ever made in my life. Mm-hmm. And I started doing my internship at Suburban Community Hospital. They like me. Straight out the gate, before I was even finished my internship, they hired me. You know, I would come every day. I was sure. Good with the patients, and they hired me. And I've been doing it for phlebotomy for like 10 years now.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was the best decision I ever made. I'm so happy. I go to work happy. I love my patients. All good.
It was kind of the same thing with me. Like, I came up from the cycling community. Basically, I was a bicycle mechanic for 4 years. I love that job. And like, cycling is part of me. Like, I'm going to die with my bicycle in my coffin, it looks like. But yeah. it's a passion of mine just as much as DJing is.
Okay.
Like, before we came here, before I entered this room, like, you saw me on my bike. I was thinking, just a quick lap around, because I'd never really been to Norristown.
You haven't been here?
No. It's always passing by on the way to, like, King of Prussia Mall.
Right.
So I'm always passing by this town. Let me just, like, park, set up a little bit early, just like do a quick ride, get to know my surroundings. It feels kind of like a little bit like Newport, like Wilmington a little bit, okay. When I'm back where I'm from. So I'm like, it feels familiar. You
okay,
know?
Cool.
It seems
cool.
It seems quiet, you know, it's not the hustle and bustle of what Philly is.
Oh, right.
Which is cool. Yeah. Which is nice. But generally, when I come through, it's generally to the King of Prussia Mall. And it's big ass. It's fucking get lost in it. But it's nice to know that quiet little communities like this exist.
Yeah,
that's differentiates itself from the city.
Right. But that's why I moved out here. Well, that's not why I moved out here. Mm-hmm. The reason why I moved out here was because I was living in the city. I was living in Philly.
Sure.
And my girl, she was living in King of Prussia.
Sure.
And we got together, and I was traveling out here, and she was traveling to Philly, and at one point in time, she was like, you know what? Done. We're done. We can't keep doing this. This is crazy. We got to move together. You know what I'm saying? So it was like we had to meet somewhere in the middle. And this is how I ended up in Norristown.
Okay.
But I miss, I know I do miss Philly.
Not too far. We're not too far away. You know what I mean?
I know, but it's far enough where I can't go every night.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And I know the vibe. It's like, for me, it's like a quick 40-minute, well, I don't want to say quick, but it's kind of a little inconvenient. Listen, but thankfully, I'm not too far away.
Whenever you're dealing with 76, it's not quick. Seriously, it's not quick. I hate 76. But, because, you know, I want to be in Philly more because there's stuff going on, and I want to be part of what's going on. But when I get off work, it's around 4:30-ish. By the time I hit the city, it's traffic. I wouldn't get there till like late. Then I got to come. That's a lot of people don't understand. That's why you don't see me a lot in things in Philadelphia, because mm-hmm. on certain days, because I have to come back out here. So that means I can't really stay long.
Got you.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Are you on call? Is that kind of on call?
Not on
kind
call,
of thing?
Okay. But I just can't be late and I can't miss a day.
Got you.
Because I'm the only one at my site. I'm a one-man person. So, and I don't think a lot of people understand that I have that responsibility that I just got to stand up for, and I just can't mess up. I want to be out till 3 in the morning, 2, 3 in the morning, but I know that I can't. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I want to be, but
that responsibility.
Responsibility I got to take care of, and I just can't do that. Even on the weekends, like I know I got to drive home, but I can't be drinking and, you know, doing this and
right,
because cops out here, especially on 76, they don't play.
Mm-hmm.
And especially out here in Montgomery County, they don't play. They'll mm-hmm. stop you and take your license. Mm-hmm. And I can't afford that.
Yep.
So I got to be responsible.
Yep. I've seen that one too many times. Not personally, but, you know, just cruising through at night like a 95 going back home. It's like you see that one cop on the side of the road.
Exactly.
It's like you know when to go 55 when it's, you know, at 55. You know what I mean?
That's right.
When you really want to push it.
Exactly.
But it's like,
you know,
pace yourself.
Exactly. Now, you know what I mean? It's a lot of, I mean, I'm going to hold you. I'm not going to hold you. There's a lot of things that I am missing by not being in Philly enough.
Got you.
And, a lot of opportunities that I could be playing at, places I could be playing.
But dude, I'll tell you what, I started DJing like circa 2016, I think, give or take around that. And you've been in the game a little bit longer than that. When you Taboo was not eye candy, Shampoo.
Right.
Shampoo was around.
Egypt was around. I was like, yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? But
so you put your time in, but I understand where you come from, where you want to stay, keep the vibe going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. You know what I mean? What year did I meet you?
Well, it was probably at Golf and Social.
Open Dex. That's exactly where we met. The Golf and Social. Oh my gosh. That's right.
Yep.
Now, basically, I wish she was around when we mean, you know, Vern.
I know Vern. Shout out to Vern Anderson.
Shout out to Vern Anderson, the dance project in the building.
Yep.
Shout out
to you, man, if you're listening right now.
Yes.
You were here right now. Cheers. Yes. I got a little wine on my right hand, so I'm going to take a quick sip. That's for you, man.
That's what's up. Yeah.
Golf and Social? Yep.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Oh man,
I'm not a big golfer kind of guy. I've tried golf, but like I feel like it took too much time. But now, since like this whole situation with COVID is happening, I might take that back up.
I'll try golf. Like it just takes too long.
I agree. Even if it's like a 9-hole game.
I tried. Me and my buddies were playing a 9-hole.
Sure.
And it was like 2 hours. I'm like, wow. And we were. And the thing is, we were just starting, and the ball was just going everywhere.
Windy ass day, I guess.
Yeah, well, no, we were just bad shots. We just can't hit the ball right. I mean, it was like we were just slicing the balls all over the place, you know. But it got me that the concept of golf is nice. It's cool.
Agreed.
If you have the skill, if you have that skill, it's a perfect game. But if you're just playing, hitting balls and stuff, just go to, what is it called?
Putt-putt.
Just go to putt-putt. You know what I mean? You just feel better about yourself.
Dude, I love that game because I understand the complexity of it and the beauty of it. It's like whenever that time I see the Masters and
you know. But them guys are good.
I know they're good, but it's like you want to emulate that shit.
You just can't.
I know, but it's like, you know, if I could play a good enough set, I can maybe emulate Carl Cox on a super, super, super good day.
Right.
But I only get this close, but that closest is what defines me and what I enjoy about it. It's like, man, that was good. I had that one shot and like I got the hole in one, but that's the only one I ever do. But right. I don't care. I did it.
I did it. That's yes. right. I did it.
Yeah, 100%. But I like that feeling. I like that feeling of like holding that that driver and just letting loose and just swinging that motherfucker.
Do you ever go to driving ranges?
I have. With the ranges, I feel that the equipment is adequate enough, but I want something more, a little bit more tailored, but that involves a little bit more money, and I'm already into cycling, and got all these different bikes and stuff like that, so it's like having another hobby that it's more of a money pit, for lack of a better phrase.
Look at DJ, how much money I spent on equipment? Seriously.
Yeah.
Come on. I mean, whatever hobby you're going to get into, you're going to spend some money.
Yes.
I got like your bike.
Sure.
Look how much money you spend on your bike.
Right.
You know
bikes.
What I mean? Bikes. Exactly. Yes. Plural. Yes, yes. I know. And that's what I'm saying. But you love it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
100%.
Listen, I can go. If I didn't. You know what? Let me tell you something.
Sure.
Let me tell you something. This is another reason why I'm not at the pinnacle where I think I should be at right now. Because when you're in a relationship, you can't do everything that you want to do. You know what I'm saying? You got time?
Yeah, I got time. I was just checking my battery.
Okay, cool beans. You can't do everything that you want to do. Like if you want to buy, like I say, I want to buy another Pioneer.
Controller,
whatever. Sure. Then you got your girl in here like, Ray, what are you doing? You don't do that. You got to do blah, 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 blah.
I got you.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Then you're stopping yourself. Then I feel bad. Like I want to be in a relationship. You know, call, you know, my girl and stuff like that.
Sure.
But sometimes I'm like, if I was by myself, I can go to London. Just go.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
Go to Ibiza.
Yep.
Just go. Don't care.
I'm waiting for that day. I'm like, I have a trip scheduled later this month to Denver.
Okay.
And I need to plan that out.
Okay.
I'm going to do a little event there.
Well,
I'm not going to do the event. I'm just going to play at the event, I should say.
Nice.
Like for like Halloween or whatever. But I love traveling. I love having that feeling. But I understand having someone behind you just being like, oh, we need to meet at, like in the middle
right.
somewhere.
Right.
And I wish I had that now, man. I wish I hadn't broken up. I wish I hadn't broken up with the girl I was seeing, but I'm not going to get too far into that. I guess there's always time for something new, but I'm in the waiting room.
Okay.
Quote unquote for that special.
Okay, but that's what I'm saying. Like it has, relationships have its pluses and minuses. Yes. Okay.
Yep.
And my minus is just that I just can't do everything I need to do. People need, a lot of people say, right, just do it. But I'm like, you're at a point where if you do it, you're going to be by yourself.
Exactly.
And I've been with someone, yeah. I've been with this person for so, like, a long time.
Sure.
And me being by myself would be like, wow, I'm lonely. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Who wants to be, you know what I mean?
I know. Oh, fuck yeah, I do. I'm feeling that now. I'm feeling that now. Every time I'm at the party, it's like, oh, I'm with a group of individuals who are like me and are beautiful people.
Right.
And
right.
Like, I feel just as good and being with them.
Listen. And that's why I get so upset when I'm at my parties. I'm grooving, I'm DJing, or just in the crowd or whatever. And I'm like, look at my clock.
Sure.
I'm like, oh, sure. It's 1:30, 2 o'clock. You know, I gotta bounce. You know what I mean? About looking at me like, Ray, why you gotta go? I'm like, and a lot of people,
listen,
a lot of people are like, Ray, sleep on the couch. Just come around, sleep on the couch or whatever.
Right.
And I'm like, nah, because if I do that, it's gonna be issues. You know what I mean? She's gonna think I'm not on her, you know, I'm somewhere I shouldn't be doing stuff I shouldn't be doing. You know what I mean? So I gotta be cool.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But man, I'm like, there's gotta be an answer to this problem. It has to be. You know what I mean?
Yeah. 100%. 100%.
I don't know. I mean,
and if there is, you're the only one who would know that. And whatever you do, the people that you surround yourself with, like people like me, will understand that. We'll be cool with that. Whatever you figure out, man.
I don't know, man. It's all good. I don't know, man. Life is something else, man. Because I've been through a lot of stuff, and just trying to get my head together, man.
That's understandable.
Right now, like, I'm going to put it out there. I agreed to speak to like a life coach.
Sure.
You know what I mean? To help me.
I think I know whom you're talking about.
Okay.
But we'll just leave it at that.
Leave it at that. Right. And to get my head right where it should be.
Yep.
Because right now my head isn't where it should be. I should be doing a lot more than what I'm doing. Something's not clicking. I don't know, because it's COVID thing going on.
Maybe. I don't know. Whatever. You'll figure it out as you go.
I have to figure it out because I have to get my head right.
Gotcha.
I'm not, like I said, when I'm doing my sets, sometimes I'm happy, sometimes I'm not.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? I should be surprised. I got a studio here. I got my keyboard, I got my drum pad.
Yeah,
right,
man,
here.
You got a nice little setup.
Thank you. You know what I mean? Thank you. I'm not using it. I got to use it.
Mm-hmm.
I should be pushing out tracks. I should be. But I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so pissed with myself. I really am.
Mm-hmm.
I got a lot of people that want to work with me. But I'm like, boy, whatever. I don't care. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I'm blaming it on a lot of stuff that I shouldn't be blaming it on.
Well, I tell you what, even though you're not producing it, or at least you not at this moment, you know, there's so many different tracks out there that you can collect on Beatport. And for me, I was thinking about producing just as well, but it's like there's so much out there that it's like if you were to live, you know, 2 or 3 lifetimes, you wouldn't hear everything. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's so much already out there that it's like, you know, it's pick and choose whatever that resonates with you and just put it out there. And it may seem like a new track to them just as well, whomever is listening.
Right.
And I always admire that about music, that there's so much selection in it, going from, you know, anything from classical to techno. You know, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't really matter. You're right.
As long as you're having fun with doing it, that's all that matters. And
yeah.
I tell you, coming from, going back to where we were, transitioning from me being a bicycle mechanic, eventually down the line, it wasn't really, after about 4 years, like it wasn't really producing enough money as I wanted to. And the bicycle company that I was at was going out of the business.
Oh.
So I was like, man, as much as I like this, you know, I've been in it, I've seen like everything. So it's like, I got to start something new. So I started, I did the welding school. Mm-hmm. It was a 6-month program. And just as much as with you and the field that you're in healthcare, it really made a difference for me just as well. And if it wasn't for that 6-month course, I wouldn't be in the position that I am now.
Nice.
To where I'm working with Bloom Energy.
Nice.
And I'm on the assembly line making fuel cells. So it's basically like
Like the fuel cells as it goes in cars and stuff?
Not in cars, but if for residential and commercial companies like Home Depot. Like, for example, they have a line of our quote-unquote fuel cells in stock where they're being used. They're being powered by natural gas and water to make the electricity for the buildings.
Oh, cool.
And stuff like Google is using that too. So basically, like, they're not relying on the grid for electricity.
Right.
Basically.
Right.
And I like that company, and good team of people that I'm working with now, thankfully.
That's good.
So I'm gonna stick to that for as long as my contract is still up, and keep going with it despite everything that I've been through so far.
Cool.
But I like it. But point is that if I didn't take the plunge with welding school, I probably wouldn't be in the position that I am now. But I didn't know that. It was kind of like a risk. It was like, you know, am I going to do this and am I going to regret it? And turns out not so much, at least for right now, thankfully,
right.
You know?
Right. Well, I guess like that's just like me and going to phlebotomy school.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I took that leap. I love it. I'm happy every day I go to work. You know what I mean? I'm not, you know, I work by myself.
Yep.
And I don't have to worry about this coworker, that coworker, you know what I'm saying? And
sure.
Listen, I'm happy. I'm really happy. Now, if I can get as happy with my music as I am my job, I'll be the perfect. I'll be perfect.
Perfect man.
Perfect man.
Top man.
I
tell you what, being here with me now, you're making strides towards that, man.
Exactly. And this is why I'm taking little steps, doing stuff like this, getting a life coach.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Working on my health.
Sure.
Because it has a lot to do with it.
Yes.
And I know that doing this music has a lot to do with image also. And that's why I'm working. That's why I'm doing this. Fixing my image. Mm-hmm.
I tell you what, man. Yoga's been helping me out. That shit's been helping me out. Because ever since I went through my little breakup, it's like I was thinking about the situation too intensely, like too much. Like it was like that was all I was thinking about. And I was like, I needed some kind of relief. And yoga was that. And Hesh. A Hesh Donnerstag helped me with that.
Shout out to Hesh. My man.
Shout out to you, man. But thank you for everything you've been doing, Hesh. But regardless, that's been helping clear my mind and also be like more flexible. Because like on the bike, I used to be on a mountain bike team, wooden wheels, for a couple years.
Mm-hmm.
And I would do races on and off. And I was like, the form for me being on the bike, I was kind of like rigid. And, you know, all that, all those bumps and all those rocks, they kind of get to your back.
Right.
So I kind of had, I still kind of have, like, I don't want to say lower back issues, but I have, like, I'm still kind of stiff.
Right.
And me just being on the yoga mat and me being with Hesh and me working on a roller on my back, it just helps me out. It just helps me be stronger in that sense of being more flexible. And flexible is strength. Flexibility is strength, you know, right. I feel. And T-Gets, shout out to T-Gen, by the way, if you're listening right now.
Shout out to T-Gen.
She is wonderful at yoga, and she's been doing it longer than me.
I know T-Gen.
Yeah, and she's like, and when I see her do like a down dog or whatever, it's like, man, I can't do it as smooth as her, but it's like that's what I'm trying to achieve. Down dog.
Down dog?
Yeah, it's like when you put your hands on the floor, you put your elbows bent, and like you raise your hips up.
Yeah.
So it's like it's kind of extending your back upward.
Okay.
Kind of, if I got that position right. But it's like little stuff like that, and just being more flexible, it creates strength as well. And that's something I'm progressing in.
I mean, I'm like 200 riders weight myself. I'm like 254, so I don't think I'll be doing yoga, my man.
Okay.
I don't think I'll have a yoga body.
It's in here. It's in here.
No.
It's in here.
You gotta be
baby
light.
Steps.
You gotta be light.
Baby steps. You gotta start somewhere. Dude, I like this fucking conversation. Like normally, when I'm interviewing guests, I have to kind of rely on my cell phone because I'm just like blurring. Because like I want to have some kind of structure and format.
Right.
But once we have flow, I'm guessing this is fucking wine. But once we have flow, we just keep going and
just keep going. Hell yeah.
But where were you born? There we go. Let's switch it up a little.
What'd you say?
Where were you born?
Oh, Philly.
Okay. Philly. Philly cat. Okay. Gotcha.
I'm born in Southwest Philly. Boop. Shout out to Southwest Philly in the building.
Dude.
52nd Street. Yeah.
Dude, I was.
Where were you born?
I was born, sadly, in Newark, Delaware. Nothing special.
Why? Why is
it small?
That's okay.
Okay, okay. I just think it doesn't have the
glam. Rep your hood.
Cool. But it doesn't have the glamour or struggle that New York has or Philly has, I feel. So it's kind of like people look down on that kind of shit.
I'm telling you, no. It's about home. I don't care where you was born, where you was raised. It's home. And it's always feel special. Always feel special to you.
I agree.
Seriously.
But I've been in this shit too. I've been in that place too long.
Yeah?
Yeah, I feel like I've been looking at potentially getting a house, maybe.
Oh, nice.
I was talking to Kyle Akers.
Uh-huh.
Over at the last event that you were DJing at. We were just talking.
Okay.
So that's potentially in the game plan for 2021, maybe.
Nice.
So
oh, good luck to you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Listen, I'm always thinking about getting a house, always. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of responsibility.
I figured.
And I'm always like, right, like where I live now, mm-hmm. they do everything. They do the lawn and take care of the street, the snow plowing, everything. So I'm like, if I get a house, I'm about to do all that myself.
I know.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
They take care of the plumbing, whatever. I'm not a good plumber.
Right.
If something breaks, I had to call somebody.
Right. I don't have to rely on my YouTube for shit to get done.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You know what I mean? So I don't know. I mean, I want a house, but that responsibility, I don't know.
But
you're young, though. I mean, see, for you, so you being young, it's good. My age, not so good. Because you get a 20-year mortgage. If I get a 20-year mortgage, I'll be 70s. You know what I mean?
Got you.
Yeah. So not so good. You know what I mean? For you, you're young.
Okay.
You do it.
Got you.
Do it.
I just figured, like, I have a decent credit score. I shouldn't say decent. I have a good credit score. So I might as well, like, take that to advantage and see where that takes me. Now, granted, maybe, like, a small apartment space probably would do the trick.
Right.
No, I don't need something massive.
Right.
I need to start somewhere, I feel.
Right.
I need to start somewhere.
Wait, let me ask you a question. Are you going to be on your own? Are you going to live by yourself?
Most likely. I don't want to, but most likely. Like, ideally, it would be with some kind of significant other, some kind of partner.
Okay.
Whom I entrust.
Okay. I mean, that's good. I mean, you need someone, like, when you first start out, sometimes it could be heavy on you. Mm-hmm. You need someone to share the burden.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing wrong with that. As long as they're reliable. Make sure they're reliable.
Right.
Whoever they are. Make sure they got a job.
You listen, Jesus.
Make sure they got a job and they go every day. Because I learned that. That's why I'm with the person I'm with. Because I know for one thing, I know bills are going to get paid.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And that's one burden I used to have when I was in the city living with whoever I was living with, whatever it was. I was kind of worried from week to week. It was something going to be like, yo, the electric bill, water bill,
right.
You know what I mean? Like, but now I'm living good. That's why I'm happy. I'm really happy. I don't have to worry about anything.
That's great.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's why I'm trying to get a lot of people at, like, don't worry. Mm-hmm. Get to a place where you don't have to worry. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I try to school people, but a lot of people, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, like, I got kids.
Sure. You know? Oh, man, that's a blessing, man.
Yeah.
That's a blessing. Good for you, man.
Yeah. I got. So I try to school people as much as I can. Cause I want people to be happy.
Yeah.
I hate when I see people that's sad and have problems and stuff like that. And cause I've been on this earth for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I've been through what a lot of people are going through right now.
Right.
You know what I mean? But everybody's going to do what they're going to do.
Yep.
So I guess they have to go through what they got to go through and they'll learn that way. But you know,
I had a roommate when I was living in South Philly. I was at 4th and Roseberry nearby the Oregon Diner.
Yeah.
Late Oregon Avenue. I was just there earlier today for breakfast. After I
nice.
Did a little scavenger hunt.
What you could eat? Hold on. What you could eat?
Oh, okay. Oh. Okay. Hold on. I got the Belgian waffle.
Love Belgian waffles.
With the powdered sugar.
No powdered sugar, though.
Okay. That's fine. A little syrup. Coffee. Must have. Little orange juice.
Nice.
Little sausage. Nice. Sausage deal. And
Scrabble? No Scrabble? What?
No Scrabble. Nah, I know it's the Delaware thing, but I'm not that. I'm not like that. No.
Whoa. Scrabble. Yo, you live in Philly. Scrabble.
No. Granted. I haven't tried it. I don't know. It's just like the texture of it and like, it looks, I don't know. It just looks like, why would I eat that shit? But I had eggs instead.
Okay, nigga.
I had some eggs. Scrambled eggs. That was cool. But I like that place. It's 24 hours.
Yeah.
It's like walking distance from where I was at. And it's like it brings back some kind of nostalgia for when I was living in South Philly.
There you go.
Nearby Robbie Tronco. Shout out to Robbie.
Shout out to Robbie.
If you're Robbie, man. Dude, if Robbie, if you're listening right now, which you're probably not, but if you are, dude, I would like to talk with you, man. It's been a little while. I gave you my controller, so.
You did?
Yeah. I gave him my older DDJ SR.
Rob Tronco?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, because he was playing at Club Atlantis. It was, I forget the name of the club before it became Atlantis.
Uh-huh.
But it was like in, like, Montgomeryville, I think. I forget where.
Okay.
I think that's the place it was called. But his older DDJ S1 Pioneer controller just shut down. Like out of nowhere, and I was in the middle of getting my 4-channel controller, so I was literally gave it to him with the case,
because really?
because for free.
That's nice.
So it's like for everything he's done, you know, with his sound, it's like you deserve this, you know, and he's been playing with it ever since.
Really?
Yeah, I saw him last time a couple months back at the at FDR.
Mm-hmm.
He did a little setup there, a little place playing some house with some other buddies, and I've seen him. I said hi. Yeah, he's still doing it. He's still doing it. I'm not sure where he is now, but regardless, cool dude, you know.
Yeah.
He's made that, what was it, Walk With Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that track, you know.
Wow.
Yeah. And I've been seeing him on occasion nearby Rittenhouse Square at this one bar, which I forget the name of. It's an Italian place.
Uh-huh.
But he's still doing it. He's cool. Playing his older, old school house.
Okay.
That's good to see a person of his age still kicking it and still enjoying life in his own way.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people know, and a lot of people know Robbie Tronco from, he was spinning at way back. Yeah.
Wow.
Like, you know, I know him for Shampoo.
Yeah. No doubt.
But he's been doing it even long, way back.
Way back.
Yeah. So I respect him for that, yeah, man. He's a cool dude. Mm-hmm. And he's always wearing that hat of his, and that's him, man.
Yeah.
That's like a metaphor for him, is that hat, and I adore him for that. And maybe I'll become that, potentially, or maybe I don't want to. But regardless.
You know what? That's interesting what you just said. Yeah. That's interesting. Becoming something. Mm. And that's where I'm at now. What do I want to become? What do I want to be known for after this is all over? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, 100%.
What is going to be? Not just my legacy, but Philly in general.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, I'm like, what legacy are we going to leave? Because it seems like we've always been in the shadow of like New York.
Well, I tell you what, some of those cats from New York are moving to Philly now.
Right.
Seriously, because all the real estate that's been popping up.
Right.
All these buildings like the Quaker Factory along 9th and Poplar. I was just literally riding my bike along there the other night, and oh my god, it's night and day compared to what it was.
Right.
It used to be old factory where they would make oatmeal, and now it's like, it's literally becoming apartments to have electricity now. It's a gorgeous lobby. It looks like a hotel, but it's not.
Right.
And I would like to think it's going to be finished construction by 2021, by next year. It's like, oh my god, it's like night and day. Like, I miss old Philly.
Right.
Even though I don't know old Philly.
Right.
But from being here for X amount of time, I know some spots.
Okay.
All that right. Have gone some change. But I think it's inevitable. So.
Well, I'm just hoping. Also, I want to see some change. Like you said, some change. Let's see what's going to happen. I mean, I'm hoping like this. Once this COVID thing is all over, I just hope it explodes.
Yeah.
The night scene in Philadelphia. That's what I'm looking to see.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
And you know, I was looking. I was I followed Chill Moody on Instagram,
mm-hmm.
And he was like, he posted up on Instagram. Someone posted, it's like the press tours don't come to Philly. They always come to New York.
That's
some
what I'm
reason,
saying. Yeah.
But like the big like top notch stars come here, like you know, Mark Knight was here.
Mm-hmm.
All those cats that who had rumor.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Hey, see, that's what I'm saying. What, like, why are we losing places like that? Like rumors, like that was a big spot.
That was Thursdays.
Yeah.
Thursdays was a shit.
It
free.
Was free.
Free, dude. I saw Christian Smith.
Yeah.
Free. I saw fucking Layback Luke.
Yes.
I saw Dorley. Man, all these other top
we
name.
We need more
dudes.
Places like that.
Mm-hmm.
We do. Hopefully someone will invest in, and like you said, if people from New York are coming down to Philadelphia, and Philadelphia is going to be exploding with population, we need places.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We have talent here. We have fantastic DJs here. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we do.
So I think we should just hope something happens. I really do. I do.
I agree. And I hope that when it does happen, I'll be around to see it for sure. How did you get into music?
Oh, how did I get into music? My brother. My brother was a DJ. He was DJing in Philadelphia, actually, way back years ago, at a place called Smart Place. It was a gay club, and he was DJing there, and I learned all my stuff from him. Mm-hmm. Seriously, I was like, when I started DJing, I had to be around 13, 14 years old.
Sure.
You know what I mean? He would show me how to mix and everything like that, and he was, because that's the crazy part. When he was, like I say, he was mixing and stuff like that. He was into house and like deep house and house and sure. Detroit techno and stuff like that. And when I was growing up, I was young, so it was hard for me because I was in like growing up in my hip hop stage, and he was doing his thing. But I was learning both things. Mm. That's why it wasn't so hard for me to transition over to house music, because I knew a little bit about house music. Right. You know what I mean? My brother, you know what I mean? And that's how I really got into music. You know what I mean? And I just never stopped. I love music. I always had this idea when I was growing up that I was going to be big in the music industry. Now, I still have this dream. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Certain things happened that I didn't make a lot of good decisions. That's mm-hmm. why I'm still where I'm at right now. I'm in a good place. Trust me, I'm in a good place. But I always felt like I should be in a better place.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But I just didn't take them steps necessary to do that. But I'm trying now.
Now's the best time.
You know what I mean? But that's how I got into music. You know what I mean? But, and music is in my soul. It's in my soul. And I'm never going to stop doing music.
Who you listen to now?
One of my favorites now is Carl Cox. He's major.
Got you.
Green Velvet.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Hot since 82.
Okay.
You know what I mean? That's my people. Like, I love listening to. You know what I mean? So when I start producing.
Sure.
I might have to be guided by those type influences.
Gotcha. That's fine. Yeah. That's sound. And I'm listening to right now. I've been listening to a lot of Zadig on repeat. He has this one boiler room that I've been listening to. It's like an hour set. It's from like 6 years back or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Listen to that on repeat. It's like he's playing like techno on vinyl. And it's like all these old school techno tracks, which is super duper cool. I'm not sure if he produces or not. But just by listening to that set, I'm very impressed by him. Also, as well, I've been listening to a lot of Boards of Canada.
Okay.
They are more like electronica, like soft ambient kind of stuff, almost like Apex Twin kind of sort of.
Right.
But very chill kind of stuff. And I've been thinking about throwing one or two sets. I mean, one or two tracks from there in a techno set. Yeah. To keep it kind of chill.
Right. Now, what do you prefer to play? What do you like to play?
I feel I'm like the techno dude. But I can go into deep house or house, that kind of stuff, or a tech house just as well.
So I love tech house.
I agree. I feel that the rhythm that you have is tech house.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It really is. It really is. I want to. I don't know. It's kind of hard to say because you know. Shout out to Fold Theory.
Shout out.
Yes.
We see you.
When they, how can I say it? When I play my set, because they've been putting me on a lot. Both areas have been putting me on a lot. Shout out to Carlos and Ashley. But they, I think they're heavy into like techno.
Sure.
You know what I mean? And I haven't been able.
The wine's good.
I haven't been, huh?
The wine's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't been able to go straight to techno. It's. You know what I mean?
Is it almost like you making that transition from hip hop to house?
Right. Now I have to do it.
That same kind of, yeah.
Tech house sure. to techno.
Sure.
It's different. It's a faster tempo. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I've been trying. I've been downloading a lot of some techno stuff. And I just have to feel it.
Got you.
I gotta get that feeling. I gotta get that feeling. Because the thing is, this is the thing. If I try to do a straight techno set,
mm-hmm.
I have to know that it sounds good. I don't know if it sounds good. Mm-hmm. The transitioning from song to song in techno,
mm-hmm.
you know, because I haven't done it a lot, so mm-hmm. it's like, does this sound the way it's supposed to sound?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I don't know. I'm afraid. I'm kind of afraid.
If anything, just do a techno set in your room now and just record it and just listen back to it and then compare it to something and see if you're on point.
Exactly.
Just like that.
Right.
But there's a lot of good Like, I discovered techno when I went to Berlin, when I went to Germany.
Right.
And like, I was in like the epicenter for techno, but I didn't know at the time. But when I went to Tresor, mm-hmm. which is I feel my favorite club, and I feel the best club in the world, as I guess as far as techno is concerned, but I think it's a very good club, I feel. I was like, it's like you listening to it's like you listening to jazz at the Apollo. You know what I mean? It's like you're at the spot for it. You know what I mean?
That's what I'm saying.
And that's what I felt with techno. Like, I was out this like the epicenter for techno.
Right.
And I felt in awe of it, because I was like in like the cathedral of sound for that particular genre of music. And I'm so grateful for that. I'm glad I did it.
Wow, that's what I'm saying. Like you've been places, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you went to London, right?
No, I never been to London. I want to go to London.
It's great.
I want to go.
It's great. It's good, but it's kind of expensive. And I feel that it's kind of stuffy. It's more like business-like. Like, I was nearby Tower Hill.
Okay.
It's kind of like in the business kind of district.
Yeah, I want to go to Essex. I don't even heard of Essex.
Oh, okay. That's like upper UK, towards Wales.
Okay.
So, but if you go down to South London, that's where it's like a little bit more like us. It feels kind of like Philly. Like,
really?
It feels more city. It feels more city, like right? Urban. That's the word.
Yeah.
That's, it feels more urban. It feels more street.
Yeah.
I'm glad to see there's people like you and me over there. I know there is, but it's like where I had my hotel at, it was just like, felt kind of like, I don't know, like going in the center city, kind of, sort of.
Okay.
It felt more business oriented, more of a different kind of tax bracket.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of story. It's like people, like if you live in London, it's like, man, you got it. You got, like, I'm not worried about you, like, kind of, sort of, as far as money is concerned. But you've been to Punta Cana.
Oh, I love Punta Cana. Oh, my gosh. Yes.
Yeah.
I love Punta Cana. I love,
Are you a beach kind of person?
One day beach.
Okay.
Other time.
Day trip. Okay.
Yeah. I'm one day beach. I mean, when we go to like on vacation.
Sure.
I can go on the beach. I'm just doing it one day. I'm done. The rest of the time I'm at the pool.
That's fine. Have some drinks. Yeah, you know, drinks, chilling
by the room.
That's cool.
Yes. Listen, everybody, all inclusive. Whatever you do, do all inclusive. Mm. You know what I mean? But yeah.
Was it a cruise or a flight there?
Well, I went on to Punta Cana. That was a cruise.
Okay.
I've been to St. Martin, St. Thomas. That was a cruise also. I love cruising.
Gotcha.
Love cruising. That's the best.
How is it being on a cruise in comparison to being on the plane? Like, I'd rather fly than cruise.
Really?
Yeah, because it's like,
why?
With flying, at least I feel, it feels more direct and it feels more orderly. Like, I feel like as long as there's a flight attendant there, as long as there's a pilot on the plane, as long as there's like direction from how to get from one area of the airport to the other, it feels like more like a process.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas with a cruise, it's like, oh, you get into your room, but then you could do whatever you want until you get to your destination. Like a cruise feels more freeform, mm-hmm. in comparison to traveling by air. And also, not to mention, I feel it's a little bit more faster
too. Now, the crazy part, I mean, you never been on a cruise, right?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
Not a cruise. I feel like
it's different because
I know it is different.
Because I went on World Caribbean, and the ship I was on holds like 5,000 people.
Sure.
So it was like you were in, and it has a mall, it has restaurants.
Right.
It's like you're in a city.
Seriously, yeah.
On a boat.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like so cool. Seriously, you have to listen. Go on a cruise, one cruise. If you do it one time,
okay,
you'll love it. Trust me.
Have you done what was that party series that was on a cruise boat? Holy Ship.
No, I never did that. I always listen. I always wanted to do a cruise party boat.
Mm-hmm.
Always want to do a party boat. I'm going to do one. New York has them all the time.
Circle Line.
Yes.
Yep. All
the time. Yes. So, trust me. We got to do it.
Okay.
Get the info. Let's plan it.
Sure.
And then we're going to do it.
Sure.
Seriously.
We'll do something in New York with the Circle Line shit.
Yes.
Like, yes. When Lee Fackey was on Circle, mm-hmm. he was playing on his battleship. It was on a Monday. Remember that shit?
Yeah.
And it was like, man, I don't know where the fuck I should go, but I haven't heard of that dude. So I was like, he wasn't on my radar, but he played like freaking monster set.
Matter of fact, they usually have a Halloween party here in Philly at one of the ships.
In Camden. And the battleship.
Yep. And I'm gonna do one that. I'm gonna do that also. There's a lot of things. Like I said, there's stuff that I'm not doing just because. I don't want to blame it on anybody. You know what I mean?
Sure.
But I got to. I'm just gonna get in my head, Ray. You're gonna get out there and go to these parties, get your face seen, mingle, boom, network, and do what you got to do.
Yep. In a timely fashion.
In a timely fashion.
In a timely fashion. And then people will want you more. Oh man, why don't you stay for it? But yo, man, I gotta go. I gotta do stuff, man. I'm a busy man. You'll see me next weekend, boy. I'll see you around. Okay, bye. Just give me a call.
I'll call you back. Text you. DM me. I hate leaving. I hate being like that. I do, man.
Well, you know what? I tell you what. It's like, for me, at least, I used to linger a lot at the parties. Like, when it was, like, dying down, like, I used to linger a lot. I don't like that feeling because I feel like I have to do something, but I don't know what to do. So it's kind of like a gray area for me.
Really?
A little bit, yeah. It's like when everything's dying down, I feel like I should help out, like, a little bit. Like, oh, man, I should put away the speaker and help the crew, you know, with the sound or something like that. But it's like, I don't know quite what to do at that time sometimes. So it's like I leave early, earlier than, like, early, quote, unquote. But I leave, like, I just leave. I don't say bye to anybody or anything like that. I just go.
I'm like that too.
Yeah,
because I just bounce.
Because, like, I know I'll see you again.
Yeah, we all gonna see each other again.
I don't feel like wishy washy. Like I like, yo, man, I love you. Don't get me wrong, but it's like, yo, man, like, I don't exchange feelings like that. I don't want to miss you.
Right.
I don't want to miss you. I love you.
Right.
But I don't want to miss you. But I know that we'll be around again sometime.
Exactly.
And that's kind of the beauty of it.
Listen. I've always feel like that is like one of the most awkward parts of the party. Mm-hmm. When you got to say goodbye.
Right. Agreed.
I hate that.
Agreed.
You know what I mean? Because sometimes you're going to hug it out. You know what I mean?
Right. It's like, how do you say it? Yeah, I know. Like, just go, man. Just fucking go.
Yeah, let's go. And I feel bad. I know some people are like, damn, you couldn't say goodbye. You know what I mean? I know some people like that. You know what I mean? Just gonna bounce and don't say goodbye. You know what I mean? But I just feel awkward, like you said. I feel awkward.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Just say hi on Facebook or some shit. Like, we'll just continue our conversation on Facebook now, or on Insta.
Listen. I do that. The next day or the day after, I'll be like, yo, sure, it was very good seeing you at the party.
Same.
I do that all the time. So people know that I recognize that, you know.
Shout out to DJ.
We had a special time. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Shout out to DJ Damas, because I saw him last night at the Richmond Dita at Vibrations 4 at the park. And he said, what's up via Instagram. He was like, yo, man, glad to see you out. Yo, it's been a minute since I've seen him. So
right.
Like, yo, man, glad to see you. Glad to see you. It was super duper cool.
Right.
I want to continue, but I don't like saying bye. But
I know.
Regardless, it was a pleasure to meet whomever I met, I just want to leave it there.
And I meet so many great people at the parties. I talk to everybody. Always, meet so many great people. People I haven't seen in so long. I mean, it's...
Meeting new people. Yeah.
You know? Yeah. Man, it's so crazy. That's another bad part about living out here. Like, I live in Norristown. Everybody, if you didn't know, I lived in Philly, but now I live in Norristown. But everybody I talk to lives in Philly. And then I would love to be like, listen, let's meet for lunch.
Sure.
Or something. But I can't. I can't because I live out here. And a lot of people in Philly, they're not coming out of Norristown.
Yeah, I know.
I was shocked when you did it.
I know. I travel.
I was shocked. I'm going to see if he's going to come see me. I was like, come see, you know, come, let's do this out here. Because I always test people, a lot of people. I'll be like, listen, I live in Norristown. Come see me.
Well, you know what?
Just to see if they'll take that trip down 76.
Right.
You know what I mean? Now, I'm shocked you did it. You did it.
Well, right. I tell you what.
I give you props.
Thank you. But, you know, because I know how it feels to be the outsider, because I am the outsider now. Because I don't live in Philly.
Where do you live at?
I live in Delaware.
Are you still living? I thought, whoa.
No.
No, you still live in Delaware?
Yeah.
I did. I said, where'd you grow up at? You were like, I grew up in Delaware.
Yeah, I grew up
in Delaware. You're still in Delaware?
Yeah.
No way.
I was living in Philly for a little bit, though.
Okay.
But then had to come back for the job and stuff like that and learn welding and stuff like that. But
oh, yeah. I thought you was in Philly. I didn't know you was living in still living in Delaware.
No.
Are you? That is a hike.
Yeah. So I know how it feels.
You're taking 95.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I know how it feels to make the hike. Every single fucking party.
Dude.
Almost.
Dude.
I know.
Wow.
I know. Sometimes sleep in the car sometimes, dude.
I'm not doing that.
Yeah,
I can't sleep in the car.
It's only for a little bit.
Are you sure you sleep in the car?
If I have to.
Really?
Because, you know, you get tired behind the wheel.
That's true. Pull up. Listen. If you got to pull over, yes.
That's what I do.
Do that. Yes. I agree 100%.
Even if it's just like an hour.
Yeah, that's cool. Do what you gotta do.
Or a little coffee, whatever.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do what you gotta do. That's right.
I know how it feels to be on the outside because I still am on the outside.
That's a hike. You going from Delaware?
Yeah.
Holy moly.
Yeah. Like, okay. Especially going from New York to Delaware. Struggle sometimes too.
That is a struggle.
Yeah. Oh, and then
everybody, I thought you was in Philly. I thought you lived in Philly. I know you're Philly.
I'm there every weekend. On the early weekend, so it gives the illusion that I live there. But at least not yet, again.
Okay. All right. Cool. And do you have your own house in Delaware?
Nah, I'm back with the parents.
Okay.
I'm back with the parents, so hence why I'm kind of looking at houses.
Yeah. Like I said, that's a big step. That's a big jump.
That's a big step.
You sure don't want to get an apartment first, then move to a house?
Well, I'm going to consider living and or purchasing an apartment first.
Yeah,
that's the way that goes because I don't need too much space.
Right, if you're gonna be by yourself,
I just need a room, a kitchen, a bathroom, and if I'm lucky, a basement and my own parking space. Other than that,
That's it.
Yeah,
you're good.
Yep.
I hate when people. You know what I hate? When people try to kill themselves, when you don't have to kill yourself.
Right.
Don't. Yeah.
I feel that pressure sometimes too.
Yeah. Don't. Yeah. 'Cause I've been there. Like I said, I've been there. I did all that stuff. I'm in a good place. You know what I'm saying? I finally got, like I said, we were talking about credit earlier. I got my credit straightened out now. I'm in a real good spot. I'm ready to make some moves. Actually, I'm moving from Norristown. Everybody, listen. I'm moving from
Norristown. Special announcement.
I'm moving from Norristown. And I'm trying to move to another place called Limerick, PA.
Breaking news. You heard it here first.
Limerick, PA, next year. So I'm moving farther away from Philadelphia. But I just want to be in a good spot.
Yeah. That's fine.
You know what I mean? I just want to be in a place where my mom comfortable, my girl comfortable. Anybody come visit me is comfortable.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I feel comfortable in being here.
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about.
It's quiet. It's clean.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
How did you come up with the name DJ Devestator?
Because I devastate things.
Boom.
Boom. I devastate them beats. I devastate them turntables. Them decks. I devastate everything. Damn. Yo, tear it up.
Coming to you soon. So you into audio video? I can't do a stream. Well, I can do a stream, but it's like I can either have the video good, but I can't have the audio good, or vice versa.
Why?
Because like,
what's wrong?
I want to capture everything using my phone, but I know I have to use some kind of preamp to connect with my phone to have the audio correct. Using the iRig stuff hasn't worked out for me.
It was really good.
Yeah, now I got like it's not really an iRig. It's like a bootleg version of the iRig.
Yeah.
And I tried it out and it was like, the sound came out mono. And that's not the sound I wanted. So I feel that's more useful for guitars and stuff like that.
Right.
So I was thinking getting that Tractor Studio preamp, whatever, and hooking that up to my cell phone instead.
Wait a minute, what I have here? I just have
what, the GoPros?
I have the cameras, but my sound card. This is one from Behringer. This Behringer sound card. This right here. It's real simple.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And
clear sound.
Huh?
Clear sound. Okay.
Super clear sound. Matter of fact, I want you whenever if you can come back. I would love for you to come back and we can do a set.
Okay.
Right here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we'll stream live on Mixcloud. I don't care.
I mean, if you got time today, whatever. Yeah.
I don't know. I gotta see what time my girl. I don't know time my girl will be back.
Okay, that's fine. We'll figure it out.
Yeah, see my girl. Everything is around my girl.
That's fine.
Everything's around my girl.
That's compromise.
Because I told her you were coming down.
There's pleasure in compromise.
I told her you were coming down, and she was like, "Okay, I'm leaving." Because she's not into music like I'm into music.
Okay.
So she doesn't feel the same way that I feel about things. You know what I mean? That's why I'm like, oh, can I do this? Should I do this? Da, 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 da. Because if I say, I got to go to parties, be like, why? I'd rather you stay home with me and just be with me. Don't go to the party. I mean, she doesn't say that.
But you feel it.
You feel it. You know what I'm saying? You just feel that way. Like, oh, why you gotta go out? Why you gotta be hanging with your friends? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's not like that. She doesn't say it, but it feels that way.
I agree. I know.
You know what I mean?
I know exactly how you feel.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. So, I would love to do something now. I mean, we could. I don't give a fuck. I mean, now.
Yeah. Well, we'll figure it out.
But, you got your UPSB with you? Are you carrying on, G? Okay. Cool.
But how is Vernon and the dance project going? If that's is it kind of like a break in the action for right now, or like,
yeah,
being constant? That's another thing. I haven't seen him in a minute.
Yeah, that's another thing too. Well, I know a lot of stuff happened because of COVID. We haven't been able to do anything. But the dance project. Let me explain.
Sure.
There will always be a dance project. Okay. Excuse me a second. Sorry. There will always be a dance project with me and Vernon, but things have slowed down a lot. You know what I mean?
It's understandable.
Like I said, he lives in Fishtown.
Sure.
I live in Norristown, and we just can't meet up like we're supposed to.
That's fine.
We don't link up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I mean, we're going to have a partnership. It has to be some type of linking up,
mm-hmm.
you know? So.
Gotcha. That collaboration.
It has to be a collaboration. Mm-hmm. It has to be that. I love Vernon to death. That's my man and everything. I text him all the time. All the time I text Vern. He texts me back. We talk, you know what I mean, on the phone and everything. But as far as the partying goes, I mean, hopefully when this is all over it, we can somehow link back up and shoot some ideas out there and see how we can get this thing rolling again.
Now, speaking of Fishtown, there's one bar along Fishtown that I don't often frequent. It's maybe only been once or twice, but I know you have history by that. St. Lazarus?
Oh, the Saint. That's where we.
How did you get that started?
Well, it was my man Rogers and what's his name? Oh my God!
You know who you are.
You know who you are. It was PDG. PDG.
Yep.
That's how the whole thing started. PDG. That's how I met Vern. And that's how I met a lot of DJs, a lot of DJs, because we had something every Thursday at PDG from, was it 5 to 9?
Yeah.
We had open decks for DJs to come play, and it was the best thing ever. But PDG, it was no more.
Okay.
It was no more.
Now,
we tried to keep it alive.
Sure.
But a lot of things happened.
That's fine.
You know what I mean?
Shout out
to my man Aziz too.
Aziz, I see that we use a cool cat.
Shout out to my Aziz. Cool cat.
I was gonna say, I lost my train.
Oh my God!
POG of St. Lazarus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. There's two DJs I want to question you about. Do you know a DJ named Detana? She was like the bartender at one point.
Yeah, I know her. Of course I do. Yeah. She was the best.
Really? Okay.
But she never
seen once or twice.
Does she
ever play?
I've never got to the honor of seeing her play.
Okay.
Every time I was there at the Saint,
sure.
She was always behind the bar.
Yeah.
But I never got a chance to see her play. Mm-hmm. And have you seen her? She's somewhere.
Not recently.
Oh,
not
my
recently.
God.
Last time I saw her was at the Saint.
Really?
Yeah.
Was she working?
She was working. But I'm sorry, I think she was actually behind the decks. Don't quote me on that. This was like
I've never seen her play the Saint. I never seen her play the Saint. Mm-hmm.
But she has.
I know she plays.
And she produces as well.
Hey, listen, every time I was there playing with Vern, like sometimes we had it on Thursday nights after the PDG
was over.
We were just playing there on random Thursday nights, and she would still be at the bar, and we was always talking shop. Always talking shop.
Mm-hmm.
But I never got the chance to actually see her spin.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, man. That makes me so mad.
She played techno just as well. She produces techno.
I didn't know she played techno.
You know what?
I thought she played a very large genre of different music.
I think she's played like electronica, like indie dance kind of stuff.
Yeah. So.
But I think the first time I saw Titano spin was at God, is this? It was off this one place off Grace Ferry. Used to be a club. Lacquer.
Right.
You ever heard of that place, Lacquer?
No, I never have.
Lacquer was a old paint factory off Grace Ferry. And they would throw parties over there. And that place was like there for like a year. It was like if you knew about it, you did. If you did not know about it, it was like, yeah.
Okay, hold on. I gotta say something first. Go. I'm sorry, because my brain was like on pause for a second. My man Tommy Rogers and DJ Ha, they started PDG. I had to put that out there so everybody know. They started it and they did everything, hooked everything up with the Saint, and they asked me, Vern, and Aziv to help out, keep it running.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? To be a bit, we played a very large part in that. So I did, you know, put them names out there. Tommy Rogers and DJ Ha. They're great people, great DJs. And I had to thank them for giving us the opportunity to start the PDG. Because a lot of DJs came through PDG, you know what I'm saying? Right. So, and that's how I first met Full Theory. You know, Carlos and Ashley, you know, that's how I met them guys. And they were graceful enough to put me on their bill. And I feel very, very happy and honored for them doing that for me, you know.
Rad. But going back to Lacquer, it was an old paint factory. If you knew about it, you knew about it. If you didn't, you didn't. I think I saw her spin one night. And it was... I think they spread the word about their parties through Instagram.
Okay.
Now, I was relatively new to Instagram at the time. I'm more of a Facebook kind of guy than Instagram, even though right now I don't have Facebook on my phone because I'm trying to take a break from it.
Right.
A little bit and just check it every once in a while on my big computer in my at the house. But regardless, it's like I've only been in one, two of those parties, but it's like the room that I was in, it was kind of like almost like a very kind of like derelict, older... had like it was glass, but they illuminated it with like these uplighting, purple uplighting. It was cool. It was a small, intimate space. But from what I've heard, they used to do parties at the back, at the very back room.
Uh huh.
Very large, like warehouse space, like huge. Like you could fit like, dude, like 1,000 people in that back room. I feel see, it was massive.
Wow.
Because of the wide open. The wide open space and columns that were like surrounding it. It was super duper cool.
Right.
And I think they had a 1 month lease on it on WDKU. The local radio station.
WKDU.
Yeah, yeah. They helped out with that just as well. And I heard a SoundCloud podcast on that. And it was very like up and coming. It was like if me and you started a club,
right?
That's what it would be. It would be just me and you renting a warehouse space for like a year contract and seeing what we could do with it and just doing everything that we can within a year and just letting it go.
Wow.
Yeah.
Super,
very homegrown.
Yeah, I haven't seen her. Oh my gosh, I haven't seen Deanna. Damn. Oh. I'm going to see how I find her. I'm gonna see. I'm gonna look her up and see if I can find her.
Okay, so who is another question? Who is Sarah Tatum? I think Toolroom. A lot of people. I heard. I combed through a lot of people's older Facebook profiles for this shit, for the podcast, and she was one of the popular.
That's
DJs,
where I met.
Sarah.
That's another person.
Tatum. Sarah Tatum. I think that. Sorry, I'm butchering your last name.
I'll call Tatum.
Tatum.
There you go. That's another person I met at PDG. That's how we first met, Sarah, me and Sarah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. She's a great DJ. Mm-hmm. Great female DJ.
We got to promote that female talent just as well because they're out there just as big as the boys.
Yes. There's a lot of great oh my gosh, yes. Yeah.
And I feel that like with techno and house, there's more female DJs than there are like female hip-hop DJs, I feel. I could be wrong. But...
No, you're right. It's not a lot of, it's not a lot of female hip-hop DJs. It's a lot more tech... female DJs out there, which is great. I mean, that's a big thing now. Mm-hmm. Actually, I've seen a lot of articles on that particular topic. Why aren't there enough female producers? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And they're not getting all the credit they should be getting, which is true.
Agreed. And there's female producers out there that do the thing just as much as the boys, but if so far it's becoming kind of unnoticed.
Right.
But it's still underground because it's like if you know about it, you're super cool.
Right.
But it's like they're putting their sound out there just as much as everybody else is, and they deserve all the credit in the world for
exactly.
that.
Exactly. Exactly.
As much as anybody else does. I asked about Titana. I asked about Sarah.
Who else you want to know about?
Well, it was just those two that came up. Cool. That came up in my mind. But another spot that I'm not sure is still there. It's called The Fire.
Oh my gosh! Yes.
I've seen posts where I've never been there. Is that still there?
It's there, but it says like since COVID, I don't know if it's still
okay.
Open. I have no gotcha. Idea if it's still okay. open. I don't know gotcha. If it's still open because our places, even the Saint right now, is not open.
Right.
Which is a shame. I don't know why they're not open at all, but
I don't know.
That's crazy. And I know The Fire. I don't think that's open either.
Okay.
Well, that's a shame. Because there's some great spots. Because The Fire, not only were they letting us DJ there, they also was putting a lot of rock concerts there too.
Oh, okay.
They were doing rock concerts there. There was letting DJs DJ there. There's been shows on, comedy shows there. It was a great spot. You know, and it's a shame that what's going on is going on right now, because a lot of places are going to suffer. It's a shame. I don't know how we're going to keep it going. Like I said, if this is over, spots are going to happen.
Yeah.
New spots are going to have to open up. Mm-hmm. To take places that's closing.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's going to happen. It's going to have to happen.
And hopefully we find a solution soon with all this COVID business. But, you know, we support through, you know, GoFundMe or
right.
whatever kind of Facebook nonprofit, like charity kind of post, or we support through merchandise. Right. You know what I mean? Buy this t-shirt. It helps out the cause. You know what I mean?
Right.
But, you know, this comes to a point where they need steady income. Right. And I'm not sure if the city is willing to do that.
I don't know. It was, and that's been a thing with me too. There hasn't been a lot of backing from the city for, especially night events, like parties and stuff like that.
Sure.
Because the city of Philadelphia is known for its ballet and its orchestras. They push them heavy. Yeah. Heavy, but not the night scene enough, I think. That's why we never get a lot of cred for our Agreed. Night scene with the DJs and the party and that mm-hmm. goes on. But if you, what? Go ahead.
I was gonna say, like, with that, you know, with travel in general, you hear a lot about, you know, historic buildings. You hear a lot about the food.
Yeah, a lot of yeah.
But you don't hear so much about like the music.
Exactly.
It's a very like hidden kind of thing because it's so personal.
Right.
And with classical and orchestral music, it's very kind of prominent and very kind of almost generalized to the fact that you can promote that and you'll be all good.
You'll be all good.
But if you were to promote like house music, you'll be like, oh, what the fuck is house? You know what I mean?
And that's why I believe like a lot of people in this industry that we're doing and are in right now don't push to do more. Because they're like, why would I want to do more when they don't even push it in the city?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like that's why we don't have a lot of, a lot of names, artists, like big artists that come out of Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. What was it? What's his name? Josh Wink.
Sure.
Like, how many
The man.
Like, how many are, like, we should have way more than names, the name mentioned, coming out of Philly.
Yeah.
Than just a couple. A handful.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
With all the talent that we have here in Philadelphia, we should be name after name after name of people who made it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, oh, here, Jazzy Jeff, Fresh Prince.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Coltrane. Meek Mill. Right. Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I get so upset that we don't have that type of culture where a lot of artists are just pushed out. But it's not. Philadelphia isn't known for that. Like I said, if you do ballet, you do orchestra, you'll be a conductor. They'll push that like crazy.
Yeah,
you know. But
yo, I swear to God, I thought when I was at the Merch Medita Vibrations part, I swear to God, I thought I saw Josh Wink for a split second, but it was like old Josh Wink with like the dreads.
Oh, the dreads and everything.
Yeah, I swear to God, I thought that was him. Now, like maybe, yo, did Josh Wink grow back the dreads? I don't know, but he like that guy looks like Josh Wink. But it was like midnight, and it was pitch black, so it was like. I was second guessing myself, but by the time I had thought to ask him the question, he had already left. I was like, man, that could have been Josh Wink. I don't know.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm gonna put this out there. Like
sure.
This. Like someone like Josh Wink, who has made a name for himself. Why hasn't he started like a workshop for other artists to like?
I don't know. Maybe that's in the works. Maybe he's just like getting his family. Maybe he's working on family time. But you know what I mean?
Per se. Mm-hmm. I'm just putting it out there like Philly needs something like that.
Got you.
A workshop where the artists could be like, and then we can network with and grow something.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
I guess right now, it's just like, with the whole COVID thing, it's like, they are just relegating it to like small little gatherings, you know what I mean? Well, to the point where it's like, it hasn't gotten enough steam to where it's kind of like a thing, you know what I mean? It's more like, hey, I just meet you at the park or whatever. We do this, we do that.
That's what
it's
I'm saying.
It's not like a routine scheduled thing yet.
But that's my thing. Like, people do stuff like, let's meet up at the park and get some equipment and play it and have people come. Let's start. Let's start an event where a yearly event where it's not just a party where people get together. It's like a festival.
Sure.
Why not? Why don't we have festivals here? Why?
Well, we got the Coming to America, but I don't consider that.
And that's a festival like someone out of the city started.
That's
like Jay-Z.
But that's more like a concert. Like, that's a concert. That's not a festival.
Right, not a festival. That's what I'm trying to say. We need to start something here big in Philly that we're known for. Mm-hmm. Why? Mm-hmm. Of all the people that has DJ equipment and that can DJ and has time, why haven't we started anything?
Right.
We got to We got to start thinking big.
Well, yeah.
We got to start thinking big.
Yeah.
Seriously.
You know what I was thinking about the other day?
What were you thinking about
creating like a local Sorrel. Like, you know how Sorrel has these like big name acts, but they have them in an amazing backdrop?
Yeah.
You know, like Nina Kravitz playing behind the Alpha Tower.
Yes.
You know, Lee Fanke playing on this battleship. Like, maybe we could do that kind of like here, but just locally. Like, maybe like you playing at the Met, or you playing at the Barnes Foundation and like
the Arby's, problem you know that what I mean? Is the problem is that this is the problem.
Sure,
let me tell you who's gonna watch. You could do it. I could go in on top of the
Arby's Museum,
whatever. Arby's
okay,
Museum.
Sure.
Who's gonna watch DJ Devestator?
We will. Local
See?
Cats. Local cats. Local cats.
We have the world has to want to watch. This is what I'm talking about.
But if
we have to find a way where the world is like, whoa.
Yo, but if we have to,
what's going on in Philly?
But if we have the production for it, and let's say hypothetically Josh Wynn comes by and wants to play with you,
see
that way that one video can elevate the platform to like.
Exactly. So that's my thing. Let's who's going to talk to Josh and be like, oh, Josh, can you come?
Yeah.
Help us out. We need your name.
We need your talent. We're promoting you on whatever the latest release you have on Overum. You know what I mean? We'll promote that. We'll push that track out, and we'll make sales because of it. Hey. So, like you know where the Acme...
Stop it.
Like, you know where the Acme is nearby Girard?
Of course.
Around there. Northern Liberties. That's where I heard he's at.
Okay.
But I'll leave it at that. That's all
I know. What I'm going to do...
I don't want to blow him up like that.
I know. But... listen, that's my thing though. If I can send him a message, of course.
Sure.
But will he get back to me?
I don't know.
No. Cause everybody's like, who's you?
Right.
You know what I mean? That's what I hate about certain things. Who you? What I want to hit you back for? Listen, I'm gonna work. I wanna do something. I wanna make this place big. I wanna put Philly out there like what it should be. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
We're always playing second fiddle. I'm tired of it. We got enough talent here to just take things over.
Yep.
You know what I mean? But everybody, you know what it is? I found out too. A lot of people get comfortable. A lot of people are comfortable where they at.
That's how kind of I am now, a little
bit. See, that's what I'm talking about. With the things that you're doing, what you're doing right now, mm-hmm. with this podcast and everything, you could blow up.
Yeah, this is 18.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And even if I don't blow up, I'm having a good time with good people.
I know, but you know what I mean? But I was thinking that there's a bigger picture to everything. And as you could be like, you know what I mean? Take it from this to maybe television.
Sure.
You're having like a little show, like a little cable drawer. Like, I always think big. I don't know why. I just say, listen, why just be here when you could be here?
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? Are you, like you said, you happy, right?
I'm happy. Well, I could be happier, but I'm good where I'm at, but I want to feel more wanted, and in that same sense I want to help others out. That's kind of where I want to be at, but I'm not necessarily am at now, but I'm getting there. But
okay.
I don't know when I'll elevate myself to where I was at before.
Okay
there we go.
All right, All right. Wow.
Yeah.
It's just like, I know, I talk to people who have so much talent, so much energy and stuff like that. Like, man, I want to get with people who has that energy and that talent, that push, that drive. Let's do something big.
Speaking of doing something, I was thinking about getting into that too. A lot of people in Philly who I talk to or and I'm buddies with are have tattoos. You have tattoos.
Yeah, I got tons of tattoos.
Boom.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I got tattoos. It's hard to see because I got hair on. But
yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. I'm going to get some more, a couple more tattoos. Why don't you have any tattoos?
I don't know, because it's like, I feel like I have a good interpretation of myself through clothes rather than tattoos. Because it's like, you know, I get a tattoo, I want people to see it.
Well,
kind of, sort of, but well, I don't want to be like, I don't want it to get it twisted. Like, just because you have this on, this kind of symbol on your arm doesn't mean I'm that. You know what I mean?
But well, tattoos sometimes symbolizes things that you want to put out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? You said you're known, you want to be symbolized by your clothes that you wear?
Kind of, sort of. Like, I feel like, and it's the ease of use. Like, I could throw on a jacket and be that jacket. You know what I mean? It's like, if I wear like a fox leather biker jacket, I feel like I'm on a motorcycle and feel like I have that attitude, even though I don't own a motorcycle.
Right. You know,
I feel that kind of like attitude, that kind of like feeling of that jacket.
So that's funny that you say that. So basically, are you saying that when people see you, is a certain perception you want them to have?
A certain perception that I want them to have through what I'm wearing.
Really?
And through that's like, that's like what I'm wearing is kind of like how I feel. And I feel that's a better perception of me putting myself out there rather than a tattoo. I think to a degree. And like with tattoos, I feel like it's very like a very personal, like intimate thing.
It's personal, right?
Yeah. And I would like to know somebody who I'm very connected with, know who I am based on that, based on my tattoos. If I were to get any, if I'm on that level, then I'm doing something, then everything's on the right track. That's what I should say.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah.
So are you going to wait?
And with tattoos, I mean, with tattoos, it's a permanent thing. With clothing, it's like I could throw on something. And
but it's always changing.
Yeah. That's the cool thing about it though. It's changing. Like you have to be, it's kind of, you have to follow the trend. But follow who I am as a person.
And that's the funny thing about following the trend. It's hard for me to follow a trend. I just depend on what I feel.
Like I was wearing
I can't do that anymore. I used to be like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but you're more grounded. I feel like you're more grounded.
Grounded. That's why I don't care.
Yeah.
I mean, set me who I am. Mm-hmm. Set me for me. Don't set me for what. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just set me for who I am.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a nice guy.
Yeah.
If that's not enough.
There you go. What else do you want?
Exactly. Yeah. What else do you want? I'm not going to look at that. Look, I'm not going to dick you over. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I'm not going to steal from you. You know what I mean? I'm not going to, you know what I mean? I'm going to be a nice guy to you. Accept me for who I am.
Okay. So now I'm going to wrap this podcast up.
You're going to wrap up?
Well, I'm just going to ask, before I do though, I'm going to ask you a series of questions.
A series of questions? Oh.
Yes. This is a series of questions. Uh-oh. Is come from Bernard Pivot.
From where?
Bernard Pivot off his show Le Contour. But this got adapted by James Lipton in Inside the Actor's Studio. So this same series of questions I ask DJs. Because I feel there's parallels between actors, musicians, and DJs. I feel there's like parallels between that.
Really?
Kind of, yeah.
Think so?
Yeah, I feel so. Like, really? If you are feeling a certain way in a movie, you're going to portray that full force.
Right.
And if you feel a certain way, I feel through music, you're going to, as best as you can, portray that sound.
Okay.
And there's more parallels, I feel, than more than that. But
well, let me explain. Like, okay.
Sure.
With DJing, okay. See, this is the crazy thing about DJing. There's different types of DJs.
Yeah. There's different types of actors.
Huh?
There's different types of actors.
No, I don't believe that.
There's method actors.
Wait. Now, actor's an actor. You go to acting school, you go to acting school.
Well,
you don't go to acting school
to a degree.
You don't go to acting school for comedy. You go to acting school for acting. You might be a comedian.
But the comedian... But the comedian might be an actor or want to be an actor.
But that's what I'm saying. But you're going to go to the same acting school. You don't go to a comedian acting school. You go to acting school. So DJs, there's a different type of DJ. This is a big thing.
Okay, sure.
Even for me, I used to be that DJ that used to do proms, birthday parties, mm-hmm. weddings, blah, blah, blah. That's different, totally different from a club DJ. It's not the same.
Well, there's actors who just perform on Broadway, but there's actors who just perform at the movies. You know what I mean? Is that parallel too? Like, I'm not that actor, but I'm this actor. There's that too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like. Okay. Okay.
But anyway,
go. Let's go. Yeah,
we can go on. We can go on a minute for that.
Yeah.
Okay. 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 So, we're gonna begin.
Okay.
With our first question.
Wait. Ask a question.
Go.
How do you want it? Like the answers. What kind of answers are you looking for?
Whatever answer you feel.
At the time? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is your favorite word?
My favorite word?
Favorite word.
Peace.
What is your least favorite word?
Racism.
What turns you on?
Women.
What turns you off?
Ignorance.
What sound or noise do you love?
Music.
What sound or noise do you hate?
Repetitiveness.
What is your favorite curse word?
Fuck.
What profession other than your own would you like to attempt?
Repeat that.
What profession other than your own would you like to attempt?
Doctor.
What profession would you not want to participate in?
Comedian.
If heaven exists, what would you like to hear God say as you step through the pearly gates?
You try to do your best.
Ray, thank you so much for being on the show.
That's it. You guys have some good
ones. That was the questionnaire, though. That was the questionnaire.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's it.
James Lifton asked Robert De Niro that same questionnaire, word for word.
Word for word.
Yeah. And various other actors like Bradley Cooper, who's also from Philly.
Yes.
So I like that question. It's a hard questionnaire. People don't know how to answer it, but it's like it's very like personal, but in the moment.
Yeah, it is. You ain't lying. It's very. Yeah,
I know. I asked Alex Miles that same question. They'll say the same questions.
Do you remember his answers?
You can tune into my channel on SoundCloud and listen in to that.
Yeah, listen to that.
And also, I asked Jesus that same question.
I asked you
those same series of questions.
Wow.
It's going to be a thing in the podcast because it's like, again, it's very personal, but very like in the moment kind of sort of. It's like, even though as much as you may want to edit that, it's like, it's hard, but it's like gratifying. You know, it's hard.
Yeah, because I know. Mean, there's so many answers.
It's so existential to it.
Yeah, there's so many answers, like, especially like, professors that you wouldn't want to do. Oh my God.
But anyway, any shout outs, promos before we wrap this thing up?
Shout outs. Oh my God. All the DJs in Philadelphia. I can't remember all your names. But a ton of DJs in Philadelphia, all y'all, all the house DJs, all the hip-hop DJs. Shout out to you guys. 430, thank you for all the opportunities you gave me. My man, DJ Vern, you've been my man for a long time. My girl, she probably going to hear this. Shout out to my girl. She's going to hear this and not understand because, you know what I mean? I don't believe any harm, but, you know, life is what it is. You know what I'm saying? You have your ups and downs. Shout out to just all the listeners out there, all the party people out there. You know, I love all you guys. I mean, y'all give me a chance. Hopefully you'll see me on a big festival somewhere. You know what I mean? And say, look, I heard a guy on a podcast. You know, blah 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 blah. You know what I mean? I remember he was a small guy. Now he's a big guy.
That's right.
That's my whole thing. I want to take this to when people say, well, I remember he was down here. Now he's up there.
The next level.
But I got to get to the next level, though. And that's the hard part, getting to the next level. You know what I mean? How long does this supposed to take? Just for some people, it's instant. For some people, it takes years.
Well, I tell you what, at least for right now, I can't predict the future or anything like that, but at least for right now, I feel that everybody's kind of like at the same pace with this whole COVID thing. It's just a matter of,
Listen, you're right. Right now, this is the best part about this thing right now. Everybody's on the same playing field.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Everybody. There's no one getting blown up. Everybody is on the same playing field right now. Now, this is the key. This is why I like this. I mean, I don't like it, but once this is over, you're going to have a plan in place to put yourself out there so people can see you and know you and find you. But there's things, like I said, there's different platforms. But you have to be able, you can't be scared. And I think a lot of people are scared. We're all comfortable.
Sure.
You can't be scared anymore. You have to be able to take that leap of faith and put yourself out there and say, I'm going to be somebody.
Well, I tell you what, this is a great step towards that. Ray, thank you so much.
Oh, my man.
Thank you so much.
Hey, my man. It's been a pleasure. Thank you for coming down. Maybe if you want to, we could do a little music and
sure.
You know, I mean, I give you some more wine. I drink my Bahama Mama, and
that's what's up. But ladies and gentlemen, this is episode 18 of the podcast to a close.
Yes,
I'll put on some tech house or something like that, just as an outro. Maybe put some as an intro. Ray, thank you so much for being here, man.
My pleasure, my man. Thank you so much for listening.
Here on SoundCloud, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Leave a comment. Say hi. Make the presence be known just as much as we are. Thank you. Peace.